Now, if you're an avid listener of any of these new wave rappers, you've probably wondered why they act mysterious, why they rarely post on social media, have a limited online presence, have very few interviews, barely give updates on projects, lie and never drop. And you may think that this is just some bullshit mysterious persona that they take on just to be seen as cool or whatever. But this isn't just some little experiment they do. It's a whole art form, do you understand? The steps to become this mysterious figure actually go deeper than you think. You may be confused right now. This shit gets deeper than just not posting or dropping shit? Yeah, it really does. I know you've been annoyed by these artists' constant delays and long waits for their next project. I have been too. Even though Destroy Lonely and Ken Carson are actually starting to drop consistently, which is fucking crazy. But yeah. My philosophy used to be kinda like this. Why the fuck are they taking so long to drop their album? Now they may make enjoyable music, but there's no way they need all that time. There's no way that shit is taking you around a year to make. Like, I doubt these rappers are putting all that much effort into their music. If you really think about it, all they do is hop in the studio, talk about their Balenciaga, their Hellcat, their perk addiction, fucking somebody's bitch, and pouring up. That's it. And I'm not gonna lie, that shit is hard. But it doesn't warrant such long waits and bullshit delays and lies that we gotta deal with. I know they gotta quote-unquote perfect whatever they're making, but still. I mean, there's no way Ken Carson needed almost a whole ass year to make X. Like, I fuck with the album, but man, let's keep it real. And there's literally no fucking reason for Destroy Lonely to not do shit in 2021 and drop No Stylist in August of 2022, almost 2 years after Broken Hearts. And side note, bro, there's absolutely zero reason, fucking zero, for Gabe and Filthy to give a date for 00 Rave, drop a music video, go on a European tour, just to be silent on the supposed day of release, not drop that shit, and then say this on Twitter, which Filthy then deleted. So, now, what the fuck is going on with the album? Like, alright bro, back to the video. Now the reason for this mysterious fuckery is literally this, like this, to make people wonder what you're doing. And in this case, I'm making a whole ass video on this subject. By making people become quote unquote obsessed with your persona and aesthetic by not being that active, you essentially make them a cult fanbase, meaning that they pretty much worship you and your music. And since you're not dropping that much, it creates a higher demand for your craft. So by starving your fans, you make them appreciate every little snippet, every tweet, every IG post, and even every IG story. And then, when you finally drop, they're gonna be all over that shit. Like, look at Opium for example, right? They're like the blueprint when it comes to being mysterious. In a way, they kinda made this shit popular. And this do less, achieve more method might sound like an actual cheat code, but it's quite risky since you could fuck yourself over big time. You really just gotta be that guy to do this shit. But yeah, a lot of these new rappers that are blowing up right now are trying their hardest to stay off social media, saying shit like, oh yeah, I just don't even be on social media like that anymore. Or saying that this internet shit has played out, or whatever other lying ass shit they come up with. Like, okay buddy, we know you just want to be Opium, okay? And that shit could really backfire on them. If they're not all that up, and they just start lying and not dropping for a long time, they'll definitely lose their fans and fall off. An example of this is Sofego. He didn't drop Pink Hearts for 2 years, and when he finally dropped it, it obviously couldn't live up to the hype because of all the delays and bullshit. So literally all his fans switched up on him, and he went from being the most loved rapper in the underground that was supposed to be the next rap superstar, who had no misses, has dropped classic tapes and EPs, had a unique and catchy flow that no one could copy, to being one of the most hated rappers right now. I mean, the only reason anyone in Cardi's camp can get away with this shit is because they're Opium and they got that kind of aesthetic. Even 00 Crash Dummies and Cardi's Blunt Rollers have this persona, and they quite literally do fuck all. Like, they hide behind these labels of, oh yeah, A&R and creative director or whatever the fuck. You thought you had to be talented and actually had to do shit to be mysterious? Fuck no! Bro, look at Burberry Airy. He literally doesn't do shit. And I mean, he doesn't need to, because he's affiliated with Playboy Cardi. That's it. But man, I swear, anybody just be getting the upside down cross chain nowadays. You know, maybe if Cardi surrounded himself with less Burberry Aries, opium babies, and random homicide gangbangers, and with more Gabes, filthies, and art dealers, then maybe he'd be putting out more music. I don't know. That's just food for thought. Now, here's the general formula these rappers go by, which I've thoroughly researched for the past 2 years. The first step is to change your aesthetic. Fuck what you already had, doesn't matter how original or creative it was. You must change your profile picture to some shit like a random Asian girl, preferably a K-pop singer. You don't even need to listen to that shit. A character from a classic horror movie, an artist from a rock or metal band, or some random dark vampire VHS aesthetic bullshit you found on Pinterest. Really, the options are endless, as long as it's dark and mysterious. But the best option would be to literally just remove your profile picture altogether and use the default one. Well, that's pretty mysterious. The second step is to change the background if you are on an app that allows you to do that, like Twitter. You must change it to a cathedral, castle, skyline, or just the night sky, or I don't know, some dark demonic shit. What the fuck am I making this video for? The third step is to unfollow everybody. The ones who have mastered this art form all follow zero people to show that they're independent and that they're clouded as fuck. They don't even follow the people they know back. Well, that's pretty base in my opinion. Now the fourth step is integral, which is to literally not post, or do so extremely rarely. Rarely posting pictures, stories, and tweets really adds to your aesthetic, but requires tough training of rarely opening social media. But the trick for this is that you of course follow zero people, meaning that upon opening Instagram, you don't see shit. Although, when you decide it's time to drop some pictures, you must follow the dress code, meaning your fit must be all black. You must also make sure that the pictures are dark as fuck so you can barely see anything. It's preferable that you don't look at the camera, and you must be posted up in front of an ominous ass place, preferably a cathedral. The fifth step is to occasionally go on IG Live for a maximum of 5 seconds to preview some shit, preferably in a dark environment with some filters on to maximize the lack of visibility. Now the music you previewed, make sure that these songs never actually drop. Step 6 is to make sure music is not released at all, at least officially. Dropping throwaways on SoundCloud under different names claiming that these were leaked is how you keep the fans fed. By having a lot of leaks and minimal official releases, you make your fanbase more cult-like, since they're spending time digging through YouTube and SoundCloud to find the quote-unquote leaks. The seventh step is to say that the album is done and give a date for the release, and make sure to not actually drop on that date and delay it at least 3 times, then scrap it and start over. Now, I don't think you're ready for this one, but step 8 is to is to finally drop music. When you feel as though you've lied, delayed your album, and starved your fans enough, I'm afraid it's time to drop. Drop some music videos too, but make sure that they're released a few months apart to keep the longevity of the album going, and also drop some shitty ass merch that's overpriced as fuck. And step 9 is to finally, after all this work you've put in, go ghost. If you think about it though, if these rappers' releases were more frequent and they spent more time on social media, would their music be as in demand and their fanbases as cult-like? I guess we'll never know. But yeah, just don't end up like so fake. Hey, ain't gotta, I feel cool, man. 101. She ain't gotta.